All right, folks, so this has been a long time coming, but it's finally here. This is the Element Rival GPS sports watch from Wahoo. Now, this is pretty exciting news just because the Rival is going to be a completely new device in the GPS sports watch arena, but it's also made by Wahoo, who's already a really well-known name when it comes to bike computers and indoor bike trainers. Then if you're a triathlete, there's going to be some special features that are going to be just for you, including its highlight feature called Touchless Transitions, which basically allows you to focus on your event and not have to interact with your watch at all during your triathlon, especially during those all-important transitions. So I've been testing the Rival out for a few weeks now, and in this in-depth review, I'll be going over all the features of the Rival as well as how it performs in the sports and fitness capacity, including the GPS and heart rate accuracy. And if you do find the information in this video useful, don't be shy about hitting that like button down below, as it definitely helps the channel a lot and I appreciate it. Oh, and one more thing is that I'll also be uploading an unboxing, setup, and full interface tour of the Rival, just because I think this video is going to be long enough already. So make sure to subscribe to get a notification when that video comes out, which should be about the same day that this video comes out. So with that out of the way, let's get into the Rival. So as you expect from a multi-sport watch, the Rival comes with GPS, an optical heart rate sensor, a barometric altimeter, as well as an ambient light sensor which adjusts the backlight. It has an advertised battery life of 24 hours for GPS activities, and in standby mode, it can last up to 14 days. And I was getting about 7 to 10 days out of it on average while using it for some outdoor activities. It's a really good looking watch. It has a ceramic bezel along with a Gorilla Glass display, and being a triathlon watch, it's water resistant down to 50 meters. The Rival isn't the smallest watch by any means, but it is quite light, weighing in right around 54 grams. Now, the Rival is primarily for sports, but it does still display notifications, so it'll display text messages, calls, and emails from your phone. With text messages, these will just pop up and then you can dive in to see the full message, and it's surprisingly quite readable. There's really not much else in terms of smartwatch features at the moment, but I do know that Wahoo will be updating the Rival, so I hope to see a lot more in that department in the future. But as a sports watch, the Rival offers most of the common workout profiles that you would expect. So it has a running profile, a treadmill profile, lap swimming, open water swimming, outdoor cycling, a kicker profile for controlling a smart bike trainer, a strength training profile, yoga, and then a triathlon profile. And this is by far the neatest profile that I'll cover in just a bit. I also added this indoor cycling profile, and there's a bunch more that you can choose from that you can add within the smartphone app. You can also create custom profiles based on an existing profile, or you can just create one from scratch. To start an activity, you simply press the middle right-hand key, and then you'll be presented with a data page. The little colored ring around the bezel indicates GPS status if it's an outdoor activity. Now, although it has a 5-button configuration, navigating the device will be a bit different than what you'll find from other manufacturers. So you'll be able to scroll through widgets using the bottom two keys. The first page after the main data page displays your heart rate, and then there's an elevation display, and then the watch face, and then back to the data page. If you're familiar with Wahoo's Element bike computers, there's a feature they call Perfect View Zoom, which zooms in and out of a data page. So what this allows you to do is view just the information that you want to see at one time. It's an interesting concept, and the Rival has that built in as well. So for instance, on this running data page, it shows the active time up top, lap pace, heart rate, and then distance. But if I press a combination of two buttons together, it starts to toggle through the view with different amounts of information. On this next view, it adds cadence and current pace, and then if I press it again, it cycles through to just one data field, then two, then three. And you can customize what data fields will show on the watch via the smartphone app, where you can customize the data pages and even add more custom data pages. So before we get into how the Rival performs for GPS and heart rate, let's go over the Rival's highlight feature. And this is something called touchless transitions, which if you're a triathlete, you're probably gonna dig this. So with a lot of other watches in the market with their multi-sport profiles, what you'd have to do during triathlon transitions is that you'd have to press a specific key during transition. So you'd get out of the water, you'd press a key to start T1, and then you press the key again to start your bike leg. And you already have a lot to think about, such as like getting out of your wetsuit, trying to find your bike, putting your helmet on, and so forth. But with touchless transitions, all you have to do is basically just press the start key when you start your swim, and then press that same key again when you end your run. And then basically all the legs and all the transitions in between, well, the Rival can automatically detect them all. And this feature works really well. The touchless transition feature is available when you choose the triathlon activity profile. So you'll just press start and then start your event, and then you just start swimming. So when you're done with your swim, the Rival detects that you're in transition by monitoring the change in pressure when you get out of the water, along with algorithms that detect the change in arm movement. And then the display changes from the swim metrics to a display that shows your T1 time, your total swim time, and your overall time. It was really close in the detection, where it was just 6 seconds off compared to another watch that I was using where I was manually tracking the transitions. And then when you hop on your bike, again, it just shows when you start riding, where it shows your transition time at the bottom of the screen. It'll then automatically display the cycling related data pages so you can see that data. Now, here's what's really cool, the touchless transitions. Well, that works on the Rival all by itself. However, if you own an Element bike computer, well, Wahoo made the Rival work in conjunction with an Element, Bolt, or Roam for a feature they call multi-sport handover. So if you do have an Element, what you'll be able to do is actually view the data that's being collected on your watch on your Element bike computer on your handlebars, which is going to be a lot more convenient than viewing it on your wrist. So to demonstrate this, let's just go ahead and rewind really quickly to the beginning of the event. So before you actually start your event, what you can do is choose this multi-sport option from your Element bike computer. Your Element just waits on your bike while you do your swim in a low power standby mode. And when you're done with your swim and you get within proximity of your Element, it'll just start to mirror the data that's being displayed on your Rival. And all of this works just automatically when you choose that multi-sport option from the Element and when your Element and Rival are paired to the same smartphone app, which is probably the case for most people. But like I said, you don't need an Element bike computer to benefit from the touchless transitions. This is just more of a compliment and kind of a bonus, basically, if you already own an Element bike computer. So anyways, let's go back to the touchless transitions. So when you're done with the bike leg, the Rival then transitions to the T2 screen, where it shows the T2 time, your cycling time, and the overall time. And then as soon as you start running, the Rival will detect that based on algorithms surrounding arm movement, and then it'll display the transition screen and then move on to the running profile. And then when you're done, you just simply press the stop key as you would any other activity, and it saves the activity as a multi-sport activity with all three legs as well as all three transitions. The touchless transition feature, it works really well, and it was definitely one of those, this is pretty cool sort of moments when I first tested it. And when the activity is saved, it'll appear as a multi-sport activity in the smartphone app where it shows your total distance, total time, and then a breakdown of your swim, T1, the bike, T2, as well as the run along with the map. Now, the reason it doesn't show any data for the swim is that I chose to do a pool swim rather than open water swim just because it's wicked cold in Colorado right now. And as of launch, the triathlon profile is based on an open water swim. And then you can click on any of the individual activities to see the details of that particular portion. So with the bike, it gives a breakdown of just that information that you would normally get with the outdoor bike profile. And then with the map, what's cool is that it actually has the bike portion highlighted in blue, and then the run portion here is going to be in gray. And you can also click into each of the transitions to see the details of those portions. You can also click on the main header of the activity to see the summary of the entire activity, but here's what's cool. Let's say for some reason there was a little variance in the transition times using the touchless transition feature, like we saw before, where it was just like 6 seconds off. You'll press this Edit Legs button here, where you can actually edit each leg as well as each transition to fine-tune it using a little slider, which is pretty darn cool, or you can just enter the time manually. And then the app just updates the activity so the details of each leg are going to be spot on. And one more feature that relates to all this is something they call staged upload. So normally when you have the little toggle enabled to automatically sync your data with third-party services like Strava and Training Peaks, what would happen is that when you save your activity, it would just automatically push that data to one of those services. But with staged upload, what it'll do for multi-sport activities as well as swimming is that it'll actually ask you whether you want to edit that data before you actually upload, or you can just upload it as it is. So it's just kind of a nice, thoughtful feature. Oh, and one more thing is that as of right now, the default triathlon profile, that's going to be built around an open water swim, an outdoor bike, and an outdoor run. And as of launch, you can't create a custom multi-sport profile. So for instance, I actually did a pool swim, an outdoor bike, and an outdoor run. However, Wahoo is going to be adding the ability to create custom multi-sport profiles, and that ability should be here by the end of 2020. But Wahoo really did put a lot of thought into the triathlon features of the Rival, from the touchless transitions to the integration with the Element bike computers, all the way down to how you actually edit and save and upload those activities to your third-party services. I have to really give them a lot of props for that. So anyways, now let's go ahead and get into how the Rival performs for GPS as well as heart rate. So let's go ahead and start with GPS accuracy. So on these examples, I'll have the Rival data highlighted in orange. On this run, everything looked pretty good, and for the most part, it was pretty much spot on. If I had to nitpick on this portion here on the lower portion of the map, it did overshoot slightly into the street where I was actually on the sidewalk, but nothing crazy by any means. And you can see that reflected by the total distance, which was in line with some other test devices. All right, so now on to some GPS examples for cycling. So this ride was nearly perfect. It's hard to find a fault with this ride, but if I were to nitpick, there was one little corner right here where it cut in just slightly. Again, I kind of had to search for that fault here, and this is the worst thing I could find, really. And then for total distance and elevation, everything was also very much in line with the other test devices, so good stuff there. The Rival also does come with live tracking when it's paired to a smartphone, where you'll be able to send a link of where you're at on your ride. And before we get into heart rate, I also wanted to quickly cover the treadmill profile and how well the Rival did at estimating indoor running distances. And it was pretty impressive. It was just 5/100ths of a mile off from the distance that was recorded on the treadmill, which is pretty darn close. Treadmills can be off from time to time, but the treadmill I was using has been pretty accurate from my previous testing. However, if the distance is off for some reason, the Rival does have the ability to edit the distance when you go to save the activity, which is really nice to see. Okay, so now on to heart rate performance. So for the accuracy of the heart rate sensor, it was kind of a mixed bag. On this treadmill run, although the average heart rate was in line with some external heart rate monitors, you can see that the Rival wandered a bit here and there. It had a spike at the beginning, but it recovered and locked back on for a bit. But on the second half of the run, it had a few dips and a few spikes. Nothing drastically bad, but there's definitely room for some improvement. However, on this outdoor run, things were a bit less pretty, where it tracked low for most of the run. And then moving on to some indoor cycling, things were a bit better here. So this was a steady state ride at a moderate intensity, and things were pretty good. There are a few little blips here and there, but there's really not much to complain about here. And then moving on to some intervals, again, not bad, but not perfect. After the third interval here, there was a moment where it veered off slightly, and then on this decrease here, it varied a bit with the drop in heart rate. And then now on to probably one of the hardest tests for a wrist-based heart rate sensor, let's also check out some weight training. So during the first 6 minutes or so, it had some major challenges, but it then locked back on for a bit before this funkiness around 12 minutes or so into the session. It actually did really well through the middle portion of this workout before having some more challenges at the end. Now, those are pretty typical results when it comes to a wrist-based heart rate sensor for weight training, so I would almost always recommend getting an external heart rate strap to get the most accurate results. And then for pool swimming, it has automatic distance, lap, and interval detection, and then it'll also be able to track your rest time automatically. It'll also give you such details as your pace and stroke rate, and then a detail of your splits. Here's where you're going to be able to see a breakdown of your intervals as well as your rest, as well as strokes per interval. And then you'll also be able to edit certain information about the activity, such as the pool size, and then you can even trim the workout if you'd like, in case you've accidentally forgot to stop your watch. Now, Wahoo put a lot of work into the sport portion of the Rival, with a lot of emphasis on those triathlon functions, but when it comes to daily activity tracking, it's going to be pretty basic. In the Element smartphone app, it'll first show your total odometer with all the activities that you've recorded on your Rival, as well as activities saved from an Element bike computer. You can then see your cycling totals for the week, your workout time for the week, including your time and distance, your steps for the day and over the course of the last week, running for the week, as well as gym workouts for the week. And as of right now, there's no sleep tracking, there's not going to be any like training and performance features like recovery time, and there's a lot of potential with the Rival, and I do anticipate Wahoo adding more features down the road, and I don't have an exact list of what they're exactly doing, but they do want feedback, so definitely leave your comments down in the description below of what you'd like to see. And then finally, in terms of external sensors, you can pair both Ant Plus as well as Bluetooth sensors with the Rival, including heart rate sensors, speed and cadence sensors, as well as power meters. One specific feature in terms of running external sensors is that when you pair the Rival with a Ticker X heart rate strap, it'll actually be able to collect running dynamics, including vertical oscillation as well as ground contact time. But unfortunately, that feature is not going to be available on other external heart rate straps that can collect that data, so that's a little bit of a bummer. Oh, and the Rival can also pair to Stride foot pods, but the running power data won't actually show in the Element app as of right now. However, it is going to be built in the Fit file already, so you'll still be able to see that data in external tools like Training Peaks or the DCR Analyzer. So to wrap things up, it's really cool to see a new entry into the GPS sports watch market, especially coming from a company that already has a solid reputation with bike computers and very popular indoor bike trainers. Now, this is Wahoo's first watch, and I think they did a really cool job with the touchless transitions, and it's going to have plenty of features that make it a very capable smartwatch. But being Wahoo's first watch, there's plenty of room for improvement, and I think the Rival does have a lot of potential, such as adding more features surrounding the daily activity tracking as well as training and performance features. The performance of the Rival in a sports and fitness capacity was really good when it comes to GPS, but the heart rate sensor left me wanting a little bit more, so I did actually see improvements as I was testing this over time with firmware updates, so I hope to see even more improvements over time. Anyhow, make sure to subscribe to get a notification when the unboxing, setup, and full interface tour of the Rival comes out, which is going to be the next video right after this one. And if you like the video, also give it a thumbs up below. In the meantime, have fun out there, stay safe, and we will see you in the next video.